Hello spider peeps! So in my last video you saw me remove these cells from an old first generation iPad. But that was a bit long for one video, so this video continues the previous one. So in this video we're going to see what we can do to use these cells. So let's pick up the story just after I removed the cells from the plastic carrier board. Enjoy! Okay, so I've dismantled them now. And I think I was getting the funny readings off it because of the way that these were connected together. I still can't work out whether they were connected parallel or in series, but I think they must have been parallel. But I was getting 5 volts out of them somehow, wasn't I? Maybe it was coming through this. See, I broke this when I was taking it apart. There's a little microprocessor there, which is just hiding under that. Or I don't know whether that might be a BIOS or a flash chip. It has a flash chip look to it. And then there wasn't a processor underneath there. Yeah, I don't think that's a microprocessor. We've got a teeny little device there and some kind of, well, I assume that's a crystal. Yeah, so anyway, I've disconnected those and let's just have a look at what voltage we've got in them. So the center terminal is positive. Yeah, so I've got 4.7 there and this one got 4 volts there. Yeah, so coming out the same way. This one was just a bit of a red herring. So I think this is connected, that one there is connected to this bit. So this went across, I think, to the other positive terminal. So I think these were just ganged up together. Okay, so what to do with these? Well, here's my new thing that arrived. So I was Googling if anyone else had done this and what sort of power thing they'd got on it. And someone on Reddit had mentioned one of these. So I cheated and bought this without really looking at it because the listing said it had several different types of voltages in it. So I ordered one from Amazon and then looking at it, I think it will work as a power bank, but I've got difficulty as where to put the charge in because the charge is USB. And I think the multiple voltages here are controlled by the USB. So you remember in my other video where I did the circuit board for the SD card and the Pico and I used one of these, had to put 2 sense resistors in. I think we're going to have to do something similar to get this to give 12 volts out. But I've got another theory of how to do that. So maybe the first thing I can do after I've got rid of the horrible fibre off the edge of the boards is wire this up to one of the batteries and see whether I'll get a voltage out of it, see whether something lights up. So let's get this wired up. Okay, so probably the easiest thing to do, I'm going to pick this one because it's got more of a terminal on it, damaged the other one a little bit too much. So this thing can get cut off, then I can cut that bit off. And I should be able to just connect this. I think I'm going to try and crocodile clip this up to begin with. I really need to sort myself out with some new croc clips. Look at this. Great fun. Well, that's going to negative anyway. So let's just check whether I've got terminals on the bottom. No, I haven't. So battery plus can pop onto there. And battery minus, have to be careful it doesn't short. But battery minus can go onto there. And these cables aren't really up to this, they're not going to be up to much, but let's try and clip it in. Leave that clips on there, hopefully. And then see if I can get some lights appear on the board. Can you see that? Yeah, just about. So I don't know whether anything's happening with this, but the little button on the side, is that going to light anything up? Oh. Right, 25% lit up then. Let's try that again. So if that's 25%, I wonder whether I have to put these in parallel because I think that's fully charged. What to do? It is working though, so I wonder if I can get any power out of this. Is there any power coming out of here? Yep, not a huge amount. What was that? 2 volts? No, it's not doing it now. Yeah, I'm assuming the outside is the positive and negative, but I don't really know. But we've got some voltage coming out of it. That's not changing in any way. So let's see if I can double the voltage going into it and see what happens. So let's leave that positive on there. You get a green one now. So that positive there go on to this negative over here. And then put this positive back onto here. Alright, so that come on straight away now, but it's still showing 25, isn't it? 25%, not 100%. Then what voltage am I getting across these now? I should be getting 8 volts across these. I am getting 8 volts. Interesting. What to do? I mean, I need to work out what voltage I'm getting out of that. Where's my USB tester? All right, nothing coming out of there yet. So maybe I need to plug it into something. I'll plug it into my DJI microphone box. Let's see whether that generates anything. No, nothing coming out of there. It's not sending anything, is it? It's doing something. Is slightly warm, that chip. I just wanted to check this. This looks a bit funny. You can see how there's two traces on that side. All of those pins are all soldered together, but they all go out to a big bit of the board. So I think that's probably the power in or the power out, and then these two either side of the ground. So I think that's all right. I think it's supposed to be like that. It just looked a bit weird when I was using my normal eyes to look at it. So I don't know where I'm going now. I don't know what to do. This was the solution to my problems. Before we get to the next bit, this video is sponsored by JLC PCB, your one-stop shop for high-quality PCB prototyping. Whether you're working on a small DIY project or scaling up for bigger production runs, JLC PCB offers really cheap PCBs, fast turnaround times, and top-notch quality. Getting your designs made has never been easier, and you can even get them to populate your PCB for you. Check out the link below to see what the current promotion is. Now back to the video. Okay, so it's the next day and I've worked it out. If you see, I've now got 3 lights on there and this is almost fully charged. I worked out this button here. I looked at the instructions and it said you had to hold the button in for so many seconds to reset. And then also I was trying to put a charge in through this port, which this is supposed to be bi-directional, so I should be able to put a charge in here, but that wasn't working. But as soon as I took a micro USB and plugged it in there, I've begun to get the charge cycle, but I did mess something up. So this is the original one that I was playing with, and if you remember, I connected 2 batteries to it. Now I've looked at the instructions for this device and there's loads of different manufacturers of this device, and I think this chip here is the important bit. Yeah, it said connect 1 cell. You can connect as many cells as you want, but 1 cell. And they said you can increase the capacity, but it just has to be 1 cell. So I think what they were saying, it was going to be 1 cell, but you could put as many parallel cells in as possible. So I think what happened was, when I put 2 of them in series.
So let's see if I can double the voltage going into it and see what happens.
When I put 2 of them in series to give myself 8 volts, it blew something in that chip. And after I'd stopped filming last night, I wired up my other one like this. And I thought I'm going to solder it and not do crocodile clips, because quite often crocodile clips are cheap, the wire's cheap and there's resistance in there. As soon as I soldered this onto that board, there was a pop. So when I put this under the microscope, you can see I've blown a bit off that chip. So this is now unfortunately dead, although you can get these chips, so I might do a chip swap out later on this. But the cool thing is this now works. So this is giving power out, and if I use these cells and harvest them, I think the only thing I've got to do is stack them like this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to charge this one fully and then swap the wires over, charge this one fully. So these will both be matched cells then, and then I'll join them and connect them out to this. And then that'll give me a decent amount of capacity. I mean, these, they're obviously used. Oh no, that's 12.6. That's 12.6. So together they're about 25. So how do we get power out of this then? So what I've got to do is tell this to output 12 volts, because I need 12 volts for my external screen card. So I've got hold of some of these little things. So these are 3 all together on the same thing, but let's snap one of them off. So these are USB decoys, and you can see that you've got the USB plug there, well, actually the USB socket there, which is a pain. and you've got the two outputs. So this should fool the device it's plugged into, to this little chip here tells it to output 12 volts. Now I was really hoping, because I want to put these inside my monitor case, I was really hoping that I could just plug that directly into there, but no. All right, so I've got some little cables as well. Now sometimes it's nicer to use a cable inside, but when you start to get lots of cables, the space becomes a premium inside those cases, which is why I couldn't really do a much flatter case. But I'm hoping if I plug that in here, and I plug this one in here, I don't know whether it'll start delivering straight away. It will, right. And the little blue light on there is telling me that this is outputting PD, so 12 volts. So we're getting 12 volts there. So let's test it with our little tester now. So let's pop that one in there. Is it sending? No, it's not. So if I, in fact, here's a good example. So if I take my microphone case that I was using the other day, there we go. So it's sending out 5 volts. So that's sending out the standard amount of voltage of a USB. So that's like what I did with the two sense resistors. So let's unplug that now, and I'll plug it into my decoy, and it wakes up again, and you see it's now sending 12 volts. And we've got the 12 volts coming through there to prove it, but if I pop that on there, I should have my 12 volts coming out of that approximately, if I connect it right. There we go, minus 12 volts, got it the wrong way around. There's my 12 volts. So I've got to find some way of connecting this up inside the box or outside the box to power the monitor. In fact, I've got an idea. Let's try that now. Okay, so I've got the positive and negative on there, so I'll just get some solder on that. And that can be positive. Oh, it's red, so it will be positive. Oops, somebody said I should use blue tack on this, and that's a good idea, and I do use it normally, but this is the only piece of blue tack that I can find currently. Thank you for that suggestion. Or indeed that reminder. Right, red, go on there. Right, that's all the soldering, I think. Now I've got to just put it into this plug here. I think the center should be positive, so what polarity I've got this on. So is that the center? Yeah, so the outside should be minus. Yeah, because this wire can be quite thin inside this silicon, I've just tinned the wire as well, so it will have something extra for it to grip onto. That seems to be okay. All right, so we've got that. That's showing blue. So let's check the voltage. I wonder whether I can feel something hot, but it's so cold in the cave. I think everything is hot. I don't think it's that. It was hot when I blew the other chip out on the other one. That should be showing 12 volts. It is, and likewise, if I do it on, it's easier if I do like do it like this, just do that one, and that's showing 12 volts with center as a positive. So let's pop that in the monitor and see whether it'll power it. Well, it should be ready to do it. I mean, you'd think it would work, wouldn't you, because this screen originally was powered off two of these batteries, but let's try. Hey! All right, so there you go. So I've got to find a way of putting this inside here. Again, I might do that in another video. It's going to be quite hard because there's a few buttons and access I've got to get on this. I mean, I could turn the whole screen into a power bank as well if I wanted. Loads of different opportunities I could do with this now. That's just the no signals timer going off. So yes, I think that's proved that as well as releasing the smoke from electrical components when you put too much voltage through them, thankfully when I bought this off Amazon, because I bought it locally and not from Ali, they sent me two. I paid through the nose for it, but I got two. So I was able to do this extra one. But it's definitely proved that inside an iPad, there are loads of things that you can harvest. We've saved the screen, we've potentially saved that, we've made a power bank out of it as well. So don't throw an old iPad in the trash, in the garbage, in the rubbish. Delete as per your geographical location. All right, hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe and see what I do next. Bye.
So let's see if I can double the voltage.